I got interrupted, and basically I went and I recorded more Ghost Recon, and I just basically did not get back to this game. I kind of got screwed over by the wayside a little bit. So I did a little more exploring here and there with certain other things. And what I did find is that I did some more Korok hunting. I found a few more shrines. And I also found a few memories. In fact, I already know where two memories are, but in any event, the shrine that I was talking about earlier with the Goron is way up here. He won't let you touch it. He won't even let you enter it or go near it or even activate it as a warp point. So that's just going to stay there for now. What I think we're going to do is we're just going to keep going around to all these different shrines, see how many orbs we can accumulate, and then basically just bank them mostly for health. And then progress from there. Because, yeah, that's basically what I'm planning to do tonight. And then maybe after that, I don't know how long that will take me. For all I know, that could take me an hour. It could take me 2 hours. I don't really plan on recording much longer than 2 hours because I kind of have a little bit of a headache. And I did take some medicine for it, but, I mean, obviously, it's not going to help me much if I'm looking into a screen. So I'll hold my breath on that one, and I'll just have to wait and see. Wind guide. Well, first things first. Oh, okay, you need one of these. I'm surprised I had enough room to be able to carry it. Okay, we got monsters. I can sense them through walls. Okay. I'm worried why that's there. Oh, you know why? Because you could probably push it. Can I pick it up? Okay, we're that. Fuck, I fucked it up. Nah, I kinda got him. Is that the only one? No, there's a shit ton of them. What weapons do I even have? Do I want to use the Dragon Bone Boko Bat? I feel like I'm going to get fucked up if I try to use it. No. Okay. Nope. Wasn't going to let him get away with that. Unfortunately, it does not seem like I will be able to pull one without pulling the other. Oh shit, I have the triple ball, that's right. This is a very nice one. Ah, he actually hit me, wow. Okay, that was a very quick hit. Dude, these ancient springs had better be worth something, I swear. Oh, that killed it. Okay. What is even down here? That's a bottomless pit. It's actually the last thing I want to go into. Okay. What the hell? How'd you make this go up? No, you don't. So I need a small key from somewhere to open this up. Why does this one only have 13? Oh, this one doesn't have arms, that's why. This one just shoots shit. That actually hurt me. Wow. Alright. I thought I was far enough away. I keep thinking those are fake walls, just the way they're like sandstone a bit. Like, they look fake. I bet one of them somewhere is fake, but, you know, you would never really guess that. It would have to be pretty obvious from something else. Okay. Why would you want to do that? I think this is another gust pillar. Yeah. It seems like all these different areas have, like, really similar puzzles a little bit. Like, not to say they copy or they reuse, but it seems very similar. Come on. It's definitely aspects of it that are, like, remixed, you know? Actually, I found more two memories. No, I found three different memories while I was out and about. Alright. Okay, now I see where the challenge is going to come from. So this is not like Wind Waker where you blow the opposite way. In this game, you blow the exact way you want to go. This thing better not leave without me. Okay. Yeah, so in this one, you blow the way you want to go. See, I'm instinctively doing Wind Waker shit. Now there's that chest. Oh, no, no, no. I fucked up. Yeah, I fucked up. That's my fault. I'm so used to doing the exact opposite in Wind Waker. It's messing with me. You have to blow it the opposite way that you want to go to, like, push yourself. Maybe I should get that chest. I wonder if I can get whatever. I wonder if I can get the small key and on the way back get it. Okay. Easy. Got it. Wait, do I want to do this? It's hard to look directly up. I mean, this would project me upward. Oh, okay. So, yeah, it's a little hard to look directly up, but there you go. So what is the point of doing that? What I need to be able to do is I need to be able to throw bombs at that structure. Yeah, see? That isn't much. Now what I could do is I could suicide bomb it, but there's no guarantee I'd be able to get back up as quickly, so I want to wait a minute here. What you can do is while you're gliding, is you can cancel your glide, pull out a bomb, and immediately detonate it. And basically, yes, it's like suicide bombing. Okay. Oh, gotcha. This time around, I actually want to keep. I want to keep it attached to the balloons. I guess the leaf has infinite durability, as long as you don't hit anything. That's what it seems like to me, because I've used it quite a lot. Yeah. So I wonder, is there like a specific way I want to push the... No. Careful. It's like the Rayman powder kegs. Oh shit. It might keep going a little bit too far. I actually don't know how to set this off. It's too far. Oh my god. That's ridiculous. But it works. So I think that's the only reason to go over there. So now this makes sense, because you need this extra boost to probably make it over there. Okay, let me guess. This is our small key. So I could just drop down, right? So let me make sure. Yeah, this just takes me back to the shrine. So I can literally just drop down from here and see what's in this chest. Forest Dweller's Sword. It made this sword for Hylians. It's made of wood, clearing vines through large forests or forge paths. I'm fucked up. So technically, I don't need this leaf anymore. I'm done. I already did what I needed to do with it. Watch that not be the case, and I just fucked up. They even gave me a nice autosave in case I definitely fucked up. Nah, I'm done. I'm good. That one had a lot to it. Okay. One more and then I can level up, but I'm gonna try to do as many as I can before I get the turn in. Why is this like this? I also completed a bunch of quests. I just have to turn them in. So like the one to hunt down crickets, the one to find the raw gourmet meat. Wolves will actually drop gourmet meat if you defeat them with bombs. I mean, I don't know if that's the only requirement, but I do know that you can do that. And that's what I was doing to kind of get a whole bunch of stuff. Just running around getting rare meats and stuff. Oh, fuck. Well, where'd I drop that to? There it is. I think what I should do now is really quickly grab the memory. It's somewhere around here. There it is. It's literally right in front of the shrine. This one they kind of give right to you. So yeah, that's the one where I was like, huh, what's that like twilight looking portal in the sky? That's it right there. Yeah, except during the daytime.
Nothing. Just as I thought. It appears that this structure was designed to be exclusively accessed by the sword's chosen one. But designs can always be worked around, at least I hope. How do I get inside? I need to activate it somehow. I made it clear that I'm not in need of an escort. It seems I'm the only one with a mind of my own. I, the person in question, am fine, regardless of the king's orders. Return to the castle and tell that to my father, please.
Okay. Just trying to help.
And stop following me!
So, she wasn't very fond of him, I guess. Why are we helping her again? Alright, damn. Why do you think that the designs for the Master Sword and the Sheikah would actually have workarounds? That doesn't really seem that well thought out. It seems pretty absolute if you know the lore and you know the history. But I don't know, maybe she's just desperate. She really just does not want Link's help at all. A major test of strength. Well, this one's gonna be fun. This is a two-handed weapon. I can't use that. Is this a one-handed weapon? This is a two-handed weapon. I'm gonna get fucked up. I don't even really want to do this one. This one's gonna be just fucking rough. Actually, no. What I should do is I should use stasis so I can get time stoppage. Is this still gonna be a one-on-one or is this gonna be just fucking destructive mode? Nice, it's three weapons. 3,000 health. Okay. Oh yeah, I forgot. You can't really lock on that well. That only did about 400, not even 400 damage. Stop it. Okay, there you go. What the hell? I'm gonna have to eat food. Yeah, because I'm going to have to eat food, but I'm going to wait for stasis to come up again. I'm trying to bait it out. Is this its spin move? Okay. I'm going to eat food here. I'm going to have to stop time on this thing and really, like, lay into it. See, I almost... Dude, if I get hit, I'm gonna die. So I need to cheese this shit as much as possible. Yeah, fuck it. Let's see if this works. I don't like doing this with two-handed weapons. It's a machine, right? It should be weak to electricity. As much as I don't want to use the Thunderblade because I don't know how to get a replacement, I'll try it. There you go. Oh, shit! That was my fault. I was way too late on that. I wasn't ready for it to do the flip around. I'll have to eat that. I don't even remember how I made this. Let's not. And yes, I will need to full heal because if he hits me with another one of those, I'll die anyway. is this shit? Okay. No, he's gonna rush me. I think. At least that doesn't harm the pillars. What is it? I hit him! Okay. That didn't affect him at all. Yo, he slid right towards me. That is some creepy fucking shit. I don't like that. Do I have any, like, garbage food? Yes, I do. There you go. Let's use the expendable guardian sword. Oh, yeah, this one break its guard. Mind throwing away these weapons, because a lot of these I can get again really easily. I just want to clear this. Oh shit. Can I stop time, please? Thank you. Four health. I got it. Guardian Sword +++. Ancient Battle Axe +++, and Guardian Shield +++. There you go. Didn't even have to try to cheese with bombs. That was actually not that bad. That double attack up definitely helped. I'm lucky he didn't kill me with that one hit. Left me with a quarter of a heart. I wonder if they have it. I wonder if that's just me lucking out, or if the game legitimately will not let you get one-shotted by some things if you have full life. I actually don't know, because all the times I've been one-shotted, like with decent amounts of life, it wasn't full. At least not that I can think. It's probably luck. I probably just lucked out it does that much, specifically with my armor taken into account. Zelda wanted to get into that, too. So for the next one, I actually kind of don't want to do this one, because there's a chance that there will be a sandstorm and I won't be able to get out. What else is there? There's this one over here. There's got to be more to the north, but I got to figure out how to get to them. I didn't go north. I didn't even climb the mountains to look for them. All this, and I haven't even done the Zora quest. That's the crazy part. Like, 14 hours of stuff, haven't even touched the Zora quest. Okay, just so I don't freeze to death. Okay. Even though I'm only going to be here for a few seconds, I just want to make sure I don't take any extra damage for nothing. Directing the wind. Ooh. Now, they really like this. They love their wind. okay, I have to figure out a way to get the ball to roll that direction. But now, what would I use these metal things for? Like, if I put this down, it rolls quickly as shit. Okay, I see what I have to do. Basically, I gotta block these two entrances right here with these stone, or no, not stone, with these metal cubes. Now, let's see. That should probably roll it all the way I need it to go. I really wonder if it's literally this simple. Make sure there's no treasure chests. Did they tell you? No, there's nothing. Maybe it is just that simple then. Oh shit, that thing is going fast. Beautiful. Well, now there is something, and to get it, you have to so this might be the challenge, is that you might have to magnesis this block away the second it starts. So I actually want to do that. One, you have to magnesis that block as soon as it's beyond it, so you can use it as a stepping stone. Which is actually not that bad, honestly. I was about to say, what the fuck happened to it? Before it looked like it was going so quickly. That time it felt like forever. Please give me good weapons. Not just an ancient core. I already upgraded everything, so there's gotta be something I can do when I get to the Akala lab. Akala has a lot of really high damaging monsters, so that's quite the fun thing to invest in. Actually, speaking of Akala, let me go do those couple of side quests right now. I think I have to wait till daytime to give this guy his crickets. But I'm going to go turn in the Great Fairy money right now, since I have it on my mind, before I go ahead and spend what money I have. So we're going back here. Yeah, this is going to be a lot of, like, teleporting. Basically, this whole section of the game is just going to be teleporting back and forth. Thankfully, the game loads reasonably quick, I feel. I feel like the load times isn't really the problem. I think the biggest problem this game has is the frame rate. And a few minor things, you know, here and there. But it doesn't really take that long, all things considered. Oh shit, what the hell's that? Oh, that is the Great Fairy, okay. I was about to say, there's a shrine here I didn't see. Wonder what the Great Fairies do. There's also another shrine back there by the stable, but I'll do that in a minute. But yeah, if by the time I've done all four of the big dungeons in this game, I still don't know. Oh wow, look. It's the little typical fairies. I already took a photo of them? Apparently I did. Okay, never mind. By the time I've done all the four major dungeons, I still don't know where all the memories are. I'm just gonna look it up and figure out how to get to them. Please listen to my story. I'm the Great Fairy Kesa. This was once a beautiful spring, but as time passed, fewer and fewer travelers offered arrived to offer me rupees. As a result, my power has abandoned me. I'm nearly powerless now, so I beg your help. I need rupees to become whole again. All I need is 100 rupees. Okay. There you go. You were too kind. Why do I not like this? I don't like where this is going. Oh, okay. I was expecting something horrible to happen. She looks like a Gerudo, almost. So now my first impression of you was correct. You are most definitely pleasant to look at. How would you like to live here with me? I'm kidding, of course. But you're certainly cute when you're blushing. Okay. The materials need to enhance a piece of clothing only. Oh, okay, it's armor upgrades. I should be able to enhance your clothing a little bit. You can enhance this. All you need is the champion's tunic and silent princesses. Go right ahead. It's actually my best piece of gear. Now has a star next to it. Just remember, there are some items in the world that when twice enhanced and worn as a set can give you a nice set bonus. Only some items, though. Okay, what else? What does it need now? Completely unknown. Okay, I can upgrade both of these. I think the only one's really worth upgrading. The soldier's helm, the soldier's greaves. I might as well do all of these. I'm gonna keep this set in case I run into, like, lightning. Because that way I won't get shocked. I can just switch back to something that has decent defense at the very least. What else? Unknown. I wonder how you figure out what you need for them next, then. I actually want to see what I need to enhance the Rito pants. If I can enhance the Rito pants, I won't need the Hylian trousers. So think about it. Think of all the materials I actually acquired, and that's still not enough. Alright, this is actually going to help out a lot. I might as well upgrade both. I have the materials. Might as well. It's a shame you can't upgrade the starting gear. I thought this would be the type of game where the starting gear can be super upgraded into something really good, you know what I mean? And the climber's bandana. Do you have any other clothes? No. Okay. Turn my sisters to former glory. Come back to see me. Wait, I have to give her the gift. Yeah, gift for the great fairy. Made an offering to the... No, but I didn't give him the 500 rupees. He gave me 500. He told me I was supposed to give her 500. Take a look. I want to know why you can't strengthen it? Allow me to explain. It's impossible. Oh, so this item is just as is. You need red choo-choo jelly. What about this? If you see them... Oh, okay. So I need to help her sisters in order to be able to upgrade some of this stuff. So basically, to do more levels, you need to find more fairies. Alright, that's fair enough. I know where one of them is. One of them is in Kakariko. Alright, then we're done here. Aww. I'm gonna go back to him. I mean, he gave me all this money and I couldn't even do anything with it. Wasn't there another? No, this is the one. Okay. I also gotta go kill that Moblin in the Akala lab before the next blood moon so I can get my one soldier's broadsword from him. I like that. I like that you can get that. That guaranteed broadsword really helps. Maybe he'll be nice and just say, keep the money. You did what you needed to do. Or maybe he'll tell me to go find more fairies to give them more money. Either way, it doesn't matter to me. I think this was him, yeah. Of course. Technically, I got to make my offering. Can't thank you enough. That's it? He gave me 500. I only used 100 of it. Okay. I guess that's just my payment. Alright, well, might as well do this shrine since I'm here. Did I actually? I guess I did actually climb this. I don't remember. The last, like, 72 hours of my life has just been a blur of this game. I think I have to slowly climb this, though. Whoops. I also found that double speed potions are actually really good to make. I just wish you could make stuff like that on the go. 3 pages of food items is actually really, really short. It's not a lot when you really think about it. Aim for the moment. Okay. Guess I have to use the bow. Can it just be a normal arrow? No, probably not. I'm gonna need more than that, won't I? No. Oh, wait. I can stop time. So if I can stop time on this, then technically, couldn't I hit it with multiple arrows? Actually, you know what? If I'm gonna hit it with anything, let it be a bomb arrow. Wait. Got it. Oh, okay. I need to shoot from this. I love these triple shot bows. That's pretty sick. Wait, if this closes, I probably need to throw a bomb instead. Oh, I did not know you could just drop a bomb like that. Can you stasis? No, you cannot stasis in the air. Oh shit, look at this. No, but how would you get to that? You need to shoot it down. can legitimately hit it. The Falcon Bow. But I'm full. So you know the drill. It's worth saving. I actually really shouldn't be using this bow. This is actually one of my... This is my good bow. I should be using one of my soldier's bows. Or knight's bows. Yeah, so that immediately closes, though. Oh no, this time it stayed open. Oh, you know why? Because I used a multi-shot bow, it probably triggered twice. I was about to say, like, what the fuck am I supposed to do there? Okay, so that time I should have known not to use a multi-shot bow. But using the multi-shot bow to knock the ball off of its platform, that was perfect. That worked out so well to be able to do that. Yeah, I made stealth food. I find that if you're not making something that's going to be a full heal or a heal-based item, it's just best to stack the bonus item you want to use. Okay, I found this one too. It would be a crazy session, just running around doing shit. Maybe that's what I should do. I should save the main quest for... I don't know necessarily tomorrow, but I should save it for Friday and or Sunday, because I'm going to be busy Saturday. Yeah, because it's already been like 40 minutes. It's already been 40 minutes. Time fucking flies when you play this game. It's just that great. Moving in parallel. Okay. Can I stop time on this? Okay. And we're done. Are you serious? Yeah, I think that's it. I think we're done here. Well, that one was easy. Alright. This one's a minor test of strength. This is one of the first ones I found. I went into it, and then I realized that you can warp to shrines. You don't even need to go into them. You can just open them up, and you don't actually need to, like, do the shrine, like, enter it. You can just interact with the tablet, and then leave. That's enough to trigger it as a warp point. right? Watch the minor test be harder for me than the major. So we did a minor, a modest. No, I did two minors, a modest. No, this is minor number three. Excellent. This one's gonna drop an axe. Does he flip his axe? There we go. Oh shit, okay. I wasn't sure what the hell he was doing for a minute. Is he gonna do his aerial move? Yep. Okay, now after this he's gonna like start doing his like suicide charge. Right? Yeah, there you go. Ancient battle axe. I finally found just the normal version. A knight shield, but my inventory's full. I think I have a shield I can get rid of. These Boko ones break. I feel like I should take the knight shield. Even though this is stronger, I feel like this one is gonna break. These are gonna break. Although I could just leave it. Oh, I already took it. It's a 40, you know what I mean? In fact, let me not even use that good shield. Let me use a garbage one, just so that way later on when I lose it, it's not that big a deal. I don't like using my high-end gear unless it's on something I know is gonna really give me a hard run. I don't want to extend the fight time for. Okay. I feel a bit better now. There's this one. I'm trying to make sure I don't miss any. Want to make sure I'm not looking over one on the map, and then like 5 hours from now I'm like, oh yeah, I totally missed that one I worked so hard to find and get into, because a lot of these I had to scale cliffs, I had to do a lot of crazy stuff, I had to go to a lot of places and do a lot of shit to be able to get it, dodge a lot of high level enemies. Modest test of strength. Dude, all of these are tests of strength. Why does this game do this to me? I think it's always going to be one of these, just with varying amounts of arms. Yeah, see? It's always going to be one of these things. Oh, I don't know how the spear attack works. There we go. I wasn't sure if it was going to be from up top or what. Alright, I completely fucked up his attack back. Oh shit. No, I did not. There you go. He was going to use the axe and he completely gave up on it. Oh, nope, too early. Too early again. What garbage do I have? Here we go. Go! Yeah, these weapons do not last that long. I think I used that one a little bit before. Let's use the... let's use the soldier's broadsword. Nice. He just flops you away. That's actually hilarious. He can only hit you once with that. Too early. Dude, he took damage from it. You couldn't do anything to him. You have to, like, specifically hit him when he's not rotating at you. There you go. Yeah, I figured I was gonna have to sack it. I did that the wrong way, but I still got it off. Guardian Spear Plus, and another Ancient Battle Axe Plus. I still think I'm just going to try to collect enough Korok Seeds to be able to just upgrade my weapons. Weapon after weapon after weapon. That's basically what I want to do. Frost Spear. Attack when the blade glows blue to chill the air and freeze your foe. So that'll be good if I go to the Goron place. I'll be able to use that to my advantage. Enemies will be weak to it, so they'll probably only take a few hits and then die. I'm gonna do these five. I'm gonna intentionally leave this one because I don't want to get stranded again. It was not fun trying to escape from the desert. Although I get the feeling that I'm gonna have to go there very soon. See, I could go to the desert. I just have to stand near a shrine. I think when you stand near a shrine, they cancel out weather effects, maybe? I don't know, though, because, like, I was standing there in the middle of the sandstorm during the day. The second I stepped off it, the heat would start to, like, damage me. But the second I stepped on it, I wasn't getting hurt by it. So I don't know, because I could have sworn I've been in cold areas and I've done the exact same thing and still basically taken damage. So I don't know how that works. My dude, these are all fucking tests of strength. I mean, it's fine, but it is what it is. I actually should take a picture of one of these things. Have I taken a picture of one? Was it just a spear? Okay. Yeah, okay. You know, when you open up with cheesy shit like that, my dude, I don't like you. Oh, wow. Okay. He has no health. So was the one I just did a modest? I think it was. Oh, come on. See, all of this shit is good. The only thing that isn't good is this Guardian Spear. About to get another one anyway. There you go. This is a Guardian Spear Plus. Let me use the Guardian Spear Normal. I think this one was supposed to be done way early. That's why it's so close to the Great Plateau. Just so happens that I completely ignored going over here for the longest. There you go. I mean, again, I guess what I'm basically doing is mopping up most of the easy different side quests that we have. There's actually a memory not that far from the Great Plateau. I kind of want to do it now while I'm here. Okay. No, that's not it. This I actually already did, so I can delete that. It's right here, so you can actually literally just glide to it for the most part. It's on the edge of the lake. I still got to figure out how to get to that one on Death Mountain. And there's one in Akala by a stone statue of the goddess Hylia. So I'm going to do that when I'm ready to turn in all my points that I spent doing shrines. I'm not going to do it right now, because that'll be a good way to progress and move on. Pro tip, this is a nice area to get Hylian shrooms, a couple of different types of fish, I believe, and stamina shrooms. Oh wow, I didn't even see this Korok over here. I gotta remember, it's roughly around here. I don't remember where I put it exactly. It's somewhere. I'm gonna have to look at the picture. I think it's this one, right? Yeah. Is that the ledge? I think so. Where was the picture taken, though? The picture was taken a little bit further back. Here we go. I was just gonna say, like, what the hell? So I was a bit off before I placed the stamp.
It's the same place, 100 years later.
From here, we'll make our way to Goron City. Then, we'll need some adjustments on that divine beast so Daru can manage it as easily as possible. He's figured out how to get it to move. However, it's apparent that we still have much more to learn. What do you think? That divine beast was actually built by people. That means we should be able to understand how it works and how to use it to our advantage. These divine beasts, so much we don't know. But if we want to turn back Calamity Ganon, they're our best hope. Tell me the truth. How proficient are you right now wielding that sword on your back? Legend says that an ancient voice resonates inside it. Can you hear it yet, Hero?
Yeah, she really had doubts about him. I thought that Fi was supposed to never wake up, though. How would you be able to heal her? I don't know. She's supposed to sleep in it for all eternity. I don't know. Maybe it's just subconscious calling out. Anyway, it doesn't matter to me. Give me back my stamp. I think this one is in a frigid area. We'll do this. I like this, though. I like the fact that they have all these different shrines. Some are puzzles. Some are tests of strength. Some are basically congratulations, you found us. Yeah, it's not bad. It's not horrible. Although I think this Zelda has the least amount of dungeons of any Zelda ever, next to Wind Waker. But that's not to say that it's short, because Wind Waker is a short game. When you really, you could speedrun it, it's really short. Actually, shit, this was the perfect place to test my theory. I think as long as you stand on the shrine, you don't get harmed by effects. Well, there's a few more in cold areas that I'll be able to test it on. So it's not like all is lost or anything. Bravery's Grasp. You can just stop time. Not afraid of that. Now, why is this thing moving across the floor like this? That doesn't make any sense to me. Still don't even really know what I'm doing. Some of them need to be down so I can hit that. Okay. Actually. Let me see if I can throw this and be able to hit it. Okay.
Supposed to. Mm. Yeah, you can't do anything at least. I wish you could. You can't. cannot use your own bombs, can you? No. Can you stasis a bomb? No, you can't stasis a bomb in air. I don't think you can stasis a bomb, period. No, you can't. I wonder if that's something to do with that platform.
Oh, well, basically I spent the last 5 or so minutes fucking around, and that really didn't help me. It's, you have to use this laser, and what it is the laser will constantly move back and forth hitting this crystal, and by doing that, you can make the platforms move up and down. So otherwise, this is a very simple puzzle now. Now that I know that you can remove these, this is not going to be that hard. I just need to sync it, put it up properly. Yep, see? So every couple of seconds, these things are going to switch. In fact, I'm already done. All I have to do is write it up. Well, I wish I had known that you could lift those things off if you stasis them and launch them. But, you know what? It's fine.
It was that bad.
This shrine actually kind of stumped me for a little bit. Only because I never knew you could knock those things and make them move different places. I was like, yeah, that's 11. Okay, when we get out, let's see. If you don't have any, like, clothing or anything, and you stand on a platform, if you'll be good or not,